Federal Constitution. This is the book that is very important for all of you, especially Malaysians. Well, I am Mr. Sebastian Lee, and I'm a local Malaysian here. And today, I would like to introduce about this documentary. It is called The Malaysian Chronicles. So, the genesis of British colonization in Malaya traces back to what is known as the Treaty of Bangkor, year 1874, or in Bahasa Melayu, it's known as Perjanjian Bangkor 1874, and also the arrival of Captain Francis Light in year 1786 in the erstwhile Prince of Wales Island, better known as Penang today. So, all of you are clear?
Sir, yes? What actually happened back then?
Oh, good question, student. Okay, so it's all like this. It all begins with the Straits Settlement. So the Straits Settlement is actually three states: Penang Island, Malacca, and also Singapore back then, which British combined all of them to be called Straits Settlement, which happens in year 1824, and also follows up by the federated and non-federated Malay states. So in year 1896, the federated Malay states consists of Pahang, Selangor, Perak, and Negeri Sembilan. Whereas for the unfederated Malay states will be Perlis, Kedah, Kelantan, and Terengganu, and also Johor. Well, Johor is actually the last one to enter the unfederated Malay states, because for the Sultan hold the mightiest power back then, and not until year 1914 Johor was part of the unfederated Malay states. Okay, fellas, let me show you about British Borneo today. Sabah. When British colonized Sabah, it's called North Borneo. Whereas for Sarawak, it's known as the Kingdom of Sarawak. Okay? So, during the Kingdom of Sarawak under British colonization in year 1841, the White Rajas, which is known as the Brooke family, right? The Brooke family of British, they conquered Sarawak. Whereas for Sabah, it was conquered by what is known as North Borneo Chartered Company in year
1882.
Motto Asia for Asia. They have become part of the greatest East Asia co-progressive series. The Japanese invasion of Malaya ended with the end of World War II, when Hiroshima and Nagasaki were bombed by their enemies. They surrendered and fled Malaya before the British returned in 1945.
So today we have Mr. Al Badri, our guest of honor, as the British government representative from the UK. Mr. Al Badri, thank you for taking the time to drop by. To begin with, what is your reaction to the nullification of the Malayan Union back in 1946 in the erstwhile Malaya, which you, your forefather, had been part of the synergy to radically revolutionize the sovereign states conquered by the British? And why do you think that the nation had decided that to have Malayan Union cease to exist after just 2 years since formation?
Basically, we lost due to the three drawbacks. One, we lost because of the poor royalty and suffragility of the Malayan rulers of Sultan. We are doing that. They were preempted to many religious and ethnic efforts only. Two, to the employee by the British colonial administration, Sir Harold, in acquiring approvals from the Malaya rulers, such that they must grades on phase. And of the course, the other one would be because the implementation of equal citizenship via the judges principle is called the Malay's special rights and privileges.
Okay, so let's go back to the genesis of the formation of Malayan Union. Some sources, or mind you, propaganda claim that the British Malayan Union is much like the savior to Malaya's ruthless invasion of Japan during the World War II. So, Mr. Abadri, what say you?
Well, first of all, the information is partly true because Malaya at that time was so weak that the country became a game of a tug of a war, beginning snatch for glory and gold between foreign lands. And the one which processes powers wins at that time. So what I'm trying to say is that British came back big after Japan hoisted their white flag through the transient British military administration of Malaya, and I am must admit, if we wanted to offer Malaya her own independence, we would have left as soon as we cleared all the misses left by the land of the rising sun. However, 1st of April in 1946, we proceeded to succeed the government system with Malayan Union with the appointed Sir Edward Gent.
I could have said it better myself, Mr. Albadri. Okay, speaking of returning to Malaya after Japan surrendered, why didn't the British colonial masters just continue with their long-standing administration style of British Malaya instead of just establishing a new government called Malayan Union? Is there a difference?
It's worth pointing out what when Japan occupied Malaya, the Malays were beginning offered civil jobs in the Malay government and better treatments than the British. This so when Japan lost the war and the British returned the letter, could barely regain the authority they had before, so they had to somehow come up with a plan B. The plan B was is beginning the some people collectivity, but with the different names. The British put up a so-called the smoke and screen and replaces the British military administration with the form of the government. Of the government that instills the Malays to become politically incubated. Preparing them to administration the country.
Understood, Mr. Abadri. So how did you guys...
Sorry for saying that for you. Please stop licking me up to the British. I in no way have the legacy in the past. You are not being fair to me.
No, please wait, Mr. Abadri. We can sort this thing out. What about let's talk about how Malay Union got funding solved. Please take a seat.
Okay, about that, we'll talk. The girls reminded and serious of protested from the community finally brought down Malayan Union, and it was then replaced by the Federal
Malaya
19.
You got over there.
It's weird. I
really?
Was so concerned.
Okay.
I really didn't know what it is.
Okay.
That's the reason that I gave you a call.
I'm so intrigued to know. This might be something devastating, or it could be a threat to our country, our nation. Could you
actually
analyze
it? You can check it out.
Wow, is this so-called paper in a bottle?
It says here time capsule.
Oh,
it felt so weird. I didn't know exactly what it is.
Okay, time capsule, 1948 to 1963.
That's why I couldn't take it out.
So, till 1963, this must be of many years ago.
This
no one
is a
discovered
very long
it.
Time.
Right, it could be a curse.
Well,
can't you? I don't see anything. It's gonna be fine. You tell me what this time capsule is all about.
You sure will, Clay?
Yeah, you won't die. See? We can guarantee you that if you manage to open it and tell me what it's all about, we honor you.
Oh.
Oh my.
Oh.
Can you tell me the content of your finding?
This is about the Federation of Malaya. It's dedicated on the 1st of February. To replace Malayan Union.
And what else does it say?
Okay, it says here the Federation of Malaya maintain
mm-hmm.
its state's autonomy and respecting the
mm-hmm.
royalty and position of the Malay rulers.
Oh.
It says also here that the British reinstates the rights of the Malayan due to pressure from the Malayan and former British administrators. It also said the Federation of Malaya provided the full board power and jurisdiction to the federal government to ease on all related affairs exclusively.
Okay.
Yeah. This is treasure.
Let's just put it into the National Archive.
Maybe it can be placed in a place where it's supposed to be.
Right.
Cannot take it back.
Yes.
Cannot keep it.
No.
Okay.
What you found right here, we have to secure it for the sake of our country.
Okay.
But we will reward you in certain amount for your contribution to our nation. All right. So.
Merdeka! Merdeka! Merdeka!
In January 1956, Tunku Abdul Rahman spearheaded a trip to London with a delegation of ministries and political leaders of Malay in negotiation with the British of independence. Upon discussion, the Federation of Malay was independent on the 31st of August 1957. The Red Commissions, a body that is designed in March 1956 to draft a constitution of Federation of Malay prior to independence for a fully self-governing and independent Federation of Malay. Among the main vital point in the draft includes the formation of a story federal government to protect the right and special privilege of the Malay, to protect the position, royalty, sovereignty and power of the Malay rulers. Yang Di Bertu An Anggong as the head of the state.
The formation of Malaysia took place on 16 September 1963, and it is under five factors. First one, the ethnic balance and unity. Second, collective against communism in Borneo. Third one is economic cooperation. Fourth, United International Corporations or Diplomatic Relationships, and the last one is Independence through Unification. So, Cobalt Commission. Cobalt Commission is a commission of inquiry set up to determine whether the people of North Borneo, which is Sabah and Sarawak, supported the proposal to create the Federation of Malaysia consisting Peninsula Malaya, Brunei, Singapore. The commission was headed by former Bank of England governor, which is Lord Cobalt, and the commission was also responsible for the subsequent drafting of the Constitution of Malaya prior to the formation of Malaysia on 16 September 1963.